Namaste. Welcome to Katemira Yoga. Today, this online yoga session will be touched on yoga on the bed. As you can see, I'm actually sitting on the bed now. There are some yoga postures that actually suitable to be practiced on the bed, although not all the yoga postures. And usually those yoga posture, yoga stretch that actually done on the bed are more gentle type of yoga stretch. And if you want to practice yoga on the bed, make sure your bed is a firm type of bed. If your bed is a soft type of bed, I will not recommend you, okay, to practice yoga on the bed due to the softness that is actually not enough support. Therefore, it can actually cause injury very easily. So please make sure your bed is a firm type of bed, then you can actually practice yoga on the bed. When you can practice yoga on the bed, anytime when you're on the bed, and usually is you can practice in the morning, okay, when you just wake up, or at night, okay, before bed. Usually if you practice in the morning when you just wake up, especially for those people who actually feel very lazy, okay, to get up from the out of the bed, okay, to go to the yoga mat, okay, to do yoga practice. So you can actually practice yoga on the bed, okay, to wake up the body, to wake up the mind. And usually after a long night of sleep, okay, your body is usually stiff. So when you do yoga on the bed, it helps to release, get the tension, okay, release the stiffness, wake up the body, wake up the mind, help you feel more refreshed. Okay, before you start your day. So it's a good practice, okay? If you practice it, okay, in the morning, okay, before you wake up. And if you can, of course, you can, after that, you can get up from the bed, out of the bed, and go to the yoga mat, okay, to continue some, okay, your regular practice if you have the times. While for yoga practice at night before bed, okay, it's suitable for those people who, after a long day, okay, of work, feel tired, okay, feel stressful. So might even some people have problem, okay, falling asleep due to maybe active mind or due to stress. So if you practice some key yoga on the bed, okay, it helps you to release your stress, help you to release the tension in the body, relax the mind, quiet your active mind, and therefore it helps you to fall asleep easily also. So it's also a good practice, okay, before go to bed. So we shall start our practice now. Okay, just imagine, okay, you just wake up in the morning or before you go to sleep, okay, while you're on the bed, okay, you are lying down. Okay, first lying down at the cobra posture, Savasana. Take a couple of deep breathing. Relax the body. Relax the mind. You can go for the deep abdominal breathing. If an inhalation, feel the abdomen raising up. Hold the breath for a while. As you exhale, feel the abdomen sink it back in. Relax the body, relax the mind here. By working the breath, slowly bending your knees one by one. You can hug in the knees close towards the chest. Feel the squeeze of the abdomen. Feel a gentle stretch at the back, especially your lower back. Working the breath. Feel the squeeze, feel the stretch. Then slowly release. Feel the knee bending. Then stretching your arm. Of course, if you have a queen size bed, you can straightening arm, okay? If you don't have, your bed is too small, you can do it with the elbow bending here. Make sure the shoulder is relaxed, okay? Shoulder, elbow in the line. First within the breath, as you give a deep inhale, as an exhale, slowly dropping knee towards the right. You can turn your hips towards the left. Feel the stretch of the back there. Keep the left shoulder on the ground. Sorry. Keep the left shoulder on the back. Yeah, practice yoga on the back here. Then inhale, slowly raise the knee up. As an exhale, slowly dropping knee towards the left, then the hip towards the right. Keep your right shoulder down on the back. Then inhale, slowly back up. Exhale, knee towards right, then hip towards left. Keep the left shoulder down. Feel a gentle stretch on the back there and the hips. Then inhale, slowly bring the knees back up. Exhale, knee towards left, then hip towards right. Keep right shoulder down. This is also good practice for those people with back pain problem. So inhale back up. Exhale down. You can go as many rounds as you're comfortable with. So inhale back up. Exhale down. Feel the gentle stretch. Inhale back up. Exhale down. Feel the stretch, feel the twist. Inhale back up. Exhale down. Keep the right shoulder down on the bed. Okay, one more round. Inhale back up. Exhale down. At the last round here, hold at the posture here. The breath. With the stretch, with the twist, keep the left shoulder on the bed. But walk on the knees down towards the bed. Hold the posture. With the stretch. Inhale back up. Now the other side, exhale down, and hold at the posture here, with the breath, keep the right shoulder on the bed, while we're going the knees down towards the bed, feel the gentle stretch and twist then. Inhale, slowly back up. From here, slowly hug the knee back close towards the chest. Feeling to squeeze the abdomen. You want to cancel massage in the back. Gently. Okay. Rock the body left and right. And slowly release. With the feet apart. You're going for the bridge. As an inhale. Slowly raise the back up, bring the knee forward, chin towards the chest, keeping knee hip distance apart. Exhale, slowly down. Okay, make sure it's a firm back. Okay? If not, this is not suitable. Okay, to practice on the back. So inhale up, work the breath. Exhale down. Upper back, middle back. Lower back down. So inhale up, bring, lift the back up as you bring the knee forward, chin towards the chest. Exhale down. Upper back, middle back, lower back down. You can go for the 5 round here by working the breath. Inhale up. Exhale down. One more round. Inhale up, exhale down. Take a couple of breaths from there.
One more time, inhale up and hold and the posture stay. Hit the breath. Does the king has a stretch your arm under the bed? If you can't, if you strain your arm or shoulder with arm straight under, you can remain the arm by the side of the bed, okay? Breathe. You can go for 5 deep breathing. There's a last breath. And you release and bring the bed down. And from here, slowly hugging the knee close towards the chest here again. Feel the squeeze of the abdomen, feel a gentle stretch at the lower back, especially. Okay, from here, slowly bringing your hands here behind your thighs under the knee. Inhale. Straightening the leg. Feel the stretch on the legs there. Exhale. Bring the knee back close to the chest. So inhale. Straighten the leg. Stretch your leg if you can. Exhale. Knee back close to the chest. Inhale. Stretch your leg. Exhale, knee back close to the chest, inhale, stretch your leg, exhale, knee back close to the chest, okay, inhale, stretch your leg, now hold at the posture here, the leg stretch, holding the leg. Then from here, you can also stretch your ankle at the same time with the toe pointing up. Then flatten the toe. And feel the stretch angles there. And stretch your angles there with the toe pointing up. And flatten your feet here again. For those people who have problem, okay, straightening your leg, okay, you can always do either, okay, knee bending, okay. You can always do with the knee bending. Those who have problem, okay, straightening your leg, you can do with the knee bending. For those people even have problem holding, okay, the leg, okay, can't reach your leg, you have a yoga strike, okay, you can use the strike, okay, to help to hold the legs there. Okay. Then just work on the ankle stretching stand. This help blood key, circulate key. Do your legs and the body here. With the legs key above the head. At the same time, you're stretching your ankles over here. If you want to, you can also stretch your toe. Okay, sorry. Relax, bring the knee back across the chest, take a couple of breaths. Then arms down, palm facing the bed. Then from here, straighten the legs. For those who can't straighten the leg, you can keep the knee bent and try to hold it there. If you want to, you can also stretch your ankle here again. Let's hold the legs there. Okay, slowly bending the knees back. Okay, hug the knee across the chest. Feel the squeeze the abdomen. Feel the back press against the ground, against the back. Okay, slowly release and straightening your legs. From here, slowly turning your body around and lie down on the stomach here. And come to a cobra posture here. Just fold the arm. Legs apart. Concentric point inward or outward. Okay? Whichever way you feel comfortable. Okay, this cobra posture here. Just relax here. It also helps to relax your back. Okay, with the cobra posture. Okay, cobra posture have a calming effect. Okay, to the body and mind. So you should feel relaxed. But at this cobra posture here. Okay, from here, you go for a simple cobra posture. You can bring the leg here slightly close back.
Then rest your elbow and arm on the back and just lift up. And hold at the posture there. Okay, just stretch on the upper back. As you lift up, okay, make sure you don't collapse the shoulders here. Okay, keep lifting up. If you need to, you can bring the legs more apart. Okay, for those who are not so flexible with your back, you can bring the legs more apart. Take a couple of breaths here. Okay, slowly back to cobra posture and relax first. Okay, one more round. Lift up here again. Feel a stretch on the back here. The upper back. Just so your neck here. As you lift up, lengthening your back, your neck here. Make sure the shoulder don't collapse. Okay, slowly back to your cobra posture and relax. Okay, now next key, raise your Lucas cobra. Okay, find it on the ground, so next to the leg. That's, you can bring the hand beside your chest or by the side. As you inhale, keep the legs on the back. Let's put on the upper back, lift up. You can keep the hands above the back, okay, if you want to. Or a gentle touch on the back. Breathe. Slowly down, leg first. Okay, one more round. Okay, I will show from this view angle. Okay, so you can see more properly. Okay, back here. Okay, slowly in here. Lift up, breathe. Okay, so lean down.
Back to your cobra
posture here and relax. Now next Lucas, okay, you can go for this variation of Lucas, forehead on the ground, on the bed, so next relax, so inhale,
legs up, face up, elbow up, breathe,
hand is as a gentle touch on the hip, make sure don't use the hand to press the hip down, keeping that in line in the spine. You can either go for this version of locus, or you can also go for another version. Okay. There are a few versions you can go for, okay? Or you can even go for side. Okay, I actually have a yoga video on different version of locus. If you're interested, you can check it out. Okay, so a little. Okay, back to Kokura posture for legs. Okay, perform one more round. Go for a few breaths. Okay, choose any version you like to go for. Then slowly back down.
Okay, back to Kokura posture, relax.
Next, okay, from here, can go for a full bow pose. There's the knee bending, right hand hold right angles, left hand hold left angles, right on the bed. The next one, next, slowly, and here. Lift up, breathe. Feel the stretch and join the stretch. Go for a few breaths and slowly down.
Back the Kokura posture, relax.
Okay, go for one more round.
Make sure the elbow don't bend. Avoid the common mistake and come to full bow pose.
Finish, slowly down. Then from here, you can relax, okay? By turning the face to one side, so the other face on the bed. Shoulder relax, okay? Relax the whole body, relax the shoulder. This allow your neck a gentle stretch over here. While relaxing the body at the same time, feel a gentle stretch at the next step. You can bend the elbow slightly, so the elbow bending slightly help to relax your shoulder easily. Okay, now the other side.
Okay, the benefit is the other side. Relax the whole body, shoulder. Enjoy the gentle stretch. On the neck over here. Okay, slowly from here.
Come back to your Kokura posture here.
Okay, from here we'll come to the extended child pose. Okay, there's some people have problem come to the standard child pose. Okay, do your not so flexibility. Some people maybe have like problem rest of okay, forehead on the bed, okay, to get the neck relaxed. Okay. If that's the case, you have a bolster. You can use the bolster to help you. Just rest of forehead on the bolster. Or there's some people maybe have problem, okay, even resting the okay, buttock okay, towards the heel, okay, like hanging here, like halfway, like that. Okay. You can actually use the bolster to help you so that you can actually sit okay, on the bolster. At the same time, you can rest the forehead. These are the bolster you can make use of as like a yoga prop. Okay, from here, you slowly come up in the way that your elbow and the shoulder get in the line. This is a cat and cow pose, a different variation. It's inhale, chip back, exhale, running the back, chin towards the chest. So inhale, chip back, exhale, round the back, close towards, chin towards the chest. Okay. When you're on the yoga mat, okay, this is actually the version of the cat and cow pose. But because due to the bed, okay, even though you're on the firm bed, I will not recommend you, okay, because you can get your wrist injury easily. So therefore, this you go for this version with the arm, okay, on the bed. So inhale, arch your back. Exhale, round the back. Chin towards the chest. Finish slowly back to your extended child pose. Then from here, you can cup your hand and support your chin. Relax it. Feel the buttock close towards the heel. This also give your neck a gentle stretch. Muscle your upper back. Relax here. Or enjoy. And the stretch. So we back to the standard child. Then from here, slowly back
up. And come back to the closet sitting here. Erect the spine. And from here, go for a spinal twist here. Left hand on the right knee. Right hand on the back support. Keep the shoulder in the line. First, give a deep inhale. Extend the spine up. As you twist the body around. Keep the spine extending up. As you twist. Keep the shoulder in a line. Slowly release. Okay, now the other side. Head the spine. Keep a deep inhale. As you twist. Finish, slowly back to the front. Okay, there's some people maybe have problem, okay. Keep the spine erecting up straight, okay, by sitting on the bed with the cross leg, okay, due to the stiffness, tightness at the hips regions there. You have the bolster, make use of the bolster, you can sit on the bolster. Okay, so become more higher up, okay, where you lift up your hip, that is easier for you to keep the spine erecting up straight. Then from here, go for a twist. So also make sure your bolster is the firm type of bolster, not those very soft type, okay, which doesn't really help much, okay, in the lifting up. Okay, so the last part. Crossing the finger, stretch your arm with the palm facing up. Inhale, raise the arm up. Feel the stretch of the shoulder, arm, and raise. Keep the spine erecting up straight. Keep the arms stretching up. And try to keep the knees down. Don't lift the knee up. Use the hip joint. You have to keep the knees down. Slowly release. And bring the arms down. Same thing for those people who have problem, okay, sitting with the spine straight. You can always sit on the bolster to stretch your arm up. Okay? So when we come to the last part, just bring the hands on the thigh, palm facing up, eyes closed. If you have the time, go for a short meditation here. You can work with the deep abdominal breathing here. Press the inhale, feel the abdomen expanding. Holding the breath for a while. Then you exhale, feel the abdomen slowly contract back in. You can just go for a short meditation. You can start it off with a 5 minutes meditation. If you have the time, you can go for a longer meditation. In the meditation, just focusing on the breath or your breathing techniques. as and when any thoughts that come in to the mind, just gently pull yourself back through your breathing techniques or your breath. Once you are ready, you can gently open the eyes. Then from here, if you are practicing this yoga on the bed in the morning, then you can get up from the bed and start your day. Or if you are practicing yoga on the bed at night before bed, then from there he can straight away lie back down on the bed and go to sleep and have a sweet dream. Hope everyone enjoy today this yoga on the bed practice, and please don't forget to give my this video a thumbs up, okay, if you like it, and so subscribe to my channel if you have not. Thank you, everyone. I shall see you again. Namaste.